for the hood. Nigga, what hood, nigga? Say, stop using that fucking, that slave mentality ass reverse psychologist shit to get people to watch this motherfucking garbage ass movie, my nigga. That shit bullshit. The first shit was good. And I know you had a lower budget than that, you understand me? So don't make all them excuses talking about this black owned, we owning the movies and all that pussy ass shit. The shit garbage, my nigga. I'm a partners, you understand me, local artists, comedians. I'm glad that y'all was able to be in that type of environment and get to do some shit like that. I'm proud of y'all. But that nigga wrong for making that bullshit that movie and putting y'all niggas in that shit.
Yo, 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 it's Big Ant, man. We back. Another edition of Urban Politicians TV. Had to come tap in on Fredo Bang speaking on I Got the Hookup Too. Hey, man, you heard what the nigga said. He said he ain't feeling I Got the Hookup Too by Master P. Master P been promoting the movie heavy for the last couple weeks. We've been anticipating it because of I Got the Hookup 1. Was like a real hood classic, man. It was a real funny movie. It was good for the community, good for the culture. You know, Master P being such an influential part of this culture. You know, one of the first major independent and artists and also major independent record labels and things like that to make the type of moves that he made. You know, a lot of people see him as a role model. So we was waiting on I Got the Hookup Too, just like we waiting on Friday, the final Friday, and we waiting on these certain type of movies because of what they did for us growing up. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of people right now saying they not feeling that fucking movie, man. I don't know why they ain't feeling it. That's their personal opinion. Fredo Bang, he had his own opinion on the movie, which is nothing wrong with him having his own opinion on that movie, no matter if it's black owned, white owned, Asian owned, Mexican owned. He had his opinion, he gave it. Now the issue is probably gonna come in when he actually saying niggas is using the reverse psychology slave mentality. Now that can be taken as disrespect. That's just me being honest. That can be seen as a, you know, hey, nigga, what is you talking about? I might have to call and have a conversation with you about that. And I know where Fredo Bang is coming from. You know what I'm saying? I can look at this shit from both sides because a lot of people nowadays, they do use their voice and their stature, their popularity, their star power to actually manipulate people into believing what they got going is gold and you should and you must support it. And they talk the black-owned business shit, and they talk all these things that they really not living by. Do I think that's the case with Master P? I don't. I think Master P is actually a genuine person, but at the same time, he is a businessman. I know he did want to sell this movie. I have not seen I Got the Hookup Too. I probably won't see it until it get on Netflix or something like that. If it is going to go on Netflix, I don't even know how to download that shit. I ain't gonna lie, man. I ain't been to the movies, but to the last time. Last movie I went and seen, I think, was Get Out. And I ain't gonna lie, that shit was really light to me. They hyped me up to go spend my money at the motherfucking movie theater. And that shit was goddamn overpriced, like the movie theaters. They just charge a lot of fucking money. So I did have respect for Master P, though, going independent. You know, me trying to get me a business off the ground in the same fashion. Of course you want people to come out and support it. You know, of course you're gonna hustle it. Of course you're gonna sell it. That's business, you know, just like artists sell their music. So we really just gotta wait and see, man. Fredo Bang's a real dope artist, you know what I'm saying? Good tapes out, good music. Type him in your search engines, you won't be disappointed. You know what I'm saying? Kill You is one of my favorite songs by Fredo Bang. He dope as fuck. He always dropping good music. And we'll see, man, you know what comes of this. Fredo Bang, you know, representing Baton Rouge, doing his thing right now. Y'all tap into his music, subscribe to the channel, Urban Politicians TV. And look in the left corner, that's the actual Instagram page, man. Y'all tap into that motherfucker and tap into my personal Instagram at UrbanPoliticians_BigAnt, man. 1,000.